Hi friends, welcome to Tutors Funny channel. Today I am going to show you how to make the simple website using Spring Board. Here this is simple website I have done. I have put only three pages: home page, about us and contacts page. This full website I have made in Spring Boot application Java. Here if you go click about us, it visiting the about us page. If you click contact us, it visiting the contacts page. I just only put the heading and only. Here you can design what you want to the content, but home page only I have put it the content, right? Simple content I have put it. Now let me see how to do this system step by step, right? So first what I am going to do, so go to the Google and type Spring initializer. If you click on this first link, it visits you to the respective website for download. So here you have to check with Maven, language Java. Here check only this one. You don't check with the snapshot. This is a beta version called as. Okay, you have to check this one. It will be Spring initialize recommend for this. That's why it automatically check it. After you have to put it to your project name. I have put it to your project name as demo Spring website. I just put the names. You can put any name of this one, web, right? Now here I need jar. My Java I have installed your machine. You can check it, what is the version you are installing Java. Java 8. So this 8. So we have to select as 8. Okay. Now you have to, here you have to add the dependencies. It's a must. Okay. First I need the dependencies. All dependencies I have to, I don't need MySQL, but I have to add it now. Otherwise, there will be some error. After that, we need a Spring Web. This one also needed. After that, we need this template, HTML templates. We needed another thing. We needed JPA. JPA we no need. Just enter this all the stuff, right? JPA. Right. I just put it all the stuff, right? Structure I have to put it here. Okay, this all stuff I added. Now we have to import this things one, generate. It's downloaded successfully, right? This downloaded successfully. Now what I'm going to do is, here you have to go to the downloads file. Here we have download, I have extract them, right? Perfect, right? It's coming successfully. Now let's go to the Eclipse. I have added Eclipse. Select the Eclipse file. Here import, this time we have to import the project because I have already downloaded. Here import, here you have to select this one. Inside the general, we have selected this folder, this one, right? Click next. It asks to import this one. You have to select this one. Go to the downloads. Click on this. This is today one. This one. Okay, import this one. Sorry, this zip file we have to import it. We have done again. Demo web. Spring. Right. Now this one no needed. This one only we needed. Zip file. Maven. Maven only we have to take. Finish. It takes some time to create your project. You have to wait until this created. Right. It created successfully. Your project name is Demo Web Spring. This one, this is your project name. Okay, this is a demo project, right? Now here, first what I am going to do is, here we have added some folders, right? We have to add some folders. So the same folders we have added, right? Only I have I'm going to add a controller folder only, because I'm not going to do handle with any database or anything. I'm not handling, only the controller we need, and static pages only need. So we have to write the same simple stuff. This is your project, this is your src. Now you have to select this src, new, create the package. For the package you have to write com dot, you have to write the project name, you have to write the com dot example, the same name, right? Example dot demo web. So demo Spring Web, Spring Web dot, you have to write this one as a controller, right? Controller, right? Controller, that's the thing we have to write here, the package controller, right? Okay, this is the thing we have to write. Okay, this is the stuff we have to do, right? After that, what I am going to do is here, this only I am going to do only the static pages only. So we have created the two files, okay, HTML files inside the template folder. This is a template folder. Where is the template folder? The template folder is reside on here. Resources, the template, right? So here we have to write new. We have to create the others, say HTML file. Okay. Next, you have to name it as index.html. Right. Press enter key. You can hear. Okay. This simple template I got from the internet. This is a go to the W3 school. I got them from here, so that I have mentioned here. This is the for the example purpose. I have get it the website. Okay, the template, web template. You have just type it with W3 school web template, web template, website template. Right? You can get it. This is only the website available here. Right? The simple one is there. I got the template from here. Right? Try it like this. Right? This how I have download that one. So that's only the interface I have used like this, right? So first what I am going to do is here, go back here. This is one on your template folder, right? So here you have to go to the this website, right? Here you have to, yeah, you can find many things, right? This is it, right? Now if you go to the try yourself. Here I have get the code, all the codes I have get it here and put into my website, right? That's the stuff you have to done, okay? All the stuff. So that's the only thing I have copied and here, put it here, right? Inside this one. So I have no need to copy and paste it here. I already done on the this template. Inside template we have a inside index.html, the same file. I adjust it whatever I need. I just copy and paste over here. I explain it, right? Okay. Now here this one should be the navbar. I have explained it later on what is this one, right? This is a simple content I have pasted, only the simple content I have put it here, very simple content I have put it here, okay? Very simple content, right? I hope web designing you have a knowledge. So what is the div, all the stuff you have to learn your bootstrap tutorial. So we no need to explain. Now here we have called the images only. So this images how to call, how to import it into your project. You here when you expand your resources folder, you can have a two folders, okay? Inside the folder you can have a two folders. One is a template, another thing is a static, right? Inside the static we have to place to your image. So I have downloaded the images in download this folder. I just drag and drop this my image into the this one, static, this folder. Click OK. It is coming here. Perfect. It's working perfect. That's the only thing we have to do, right? Okay. This is HTML file. Inside the HTML file, we have to call it to the our images, right? What is the image? Lake extension JPG. We have provide the size of that one. That's the only thing here, right? This is all the stuff. The safe, the plain template, right? That's the only thing we have to do. Okay. Forget about this one. I have to explain it later on, right? After that, I have to do another thing is this things, command this one. This is the header part. So this is all the header. This all the header. So this all the header I have put into this all the header part. I have put into the command, right? This one include tag, right? So how to do the task is here. First we have to create the folder, right? I have created the folder in my this one inside the template. I have created a separate folder common, right? So you have to create a separate folder common. You have to put it the name as common. This is the efficient way we have to create the folder, right? Okay. Inside the folder we have to create a separate file header.html. So if you have a footer, you can put as a footer as a HTML as well. I didn't do the footer as well, only header.html. This is not a folder, this is a file, no? Isn't it? This is not a folder, it's a file. So here right click, new, this one others, file name is, next file name is header.html. Right, next. Okay, now here what I'm going to double click and open it. Here I'm going to go to here header. Ctrl C to copy. Back here header. Paste it here. Ctrl V to paste here. Right, this all the stuff. Right, this header. This all are bootstrap styles. I just copy from the same template. Right, only. Okay, what the template you are selected from the W3 school? The same template I have to. This all the styles. Right. I copy and I never do anything else. This is all the style. We have only we have to get it only the new tag only. Right? This new tag. This is called as a new tag. Right? This new tag we have to call it as a pages. Right? This one contact us home page and this one about us and contact us. Right? So that's the stuff we have to do. Alright. Now we go to the application properties. We have to give the link. Right? This is the simple stuff. Application property. This one we have to put it here. Ctrl C to copy, Ctrl V to paste it here. This Spring JPA, this one I have put it as a none. We don't need it. The driver I have only the put MySQL driver only. This is a port. This is a simple application. We don't need it. We already initialized the MySQL connector so that we have to put it here. Right? Or this is a port which we are running. We have to give the different port. 600 you can give the different port. Now we have to save all. Right. Now we have to call to the controller. Go to the controller part. This is a controller. We have to create the controller class, right? We have to create the controller class over here, right? So we have to create a controller class here. This is the Spring Web class. I just give the name as you can give any name. Spring Web class. Web Spring Web. I finish. This is a controller we have to create that. Right. Now here first what I am going to do is here. This is the controller we have to write. Now we have to write call it there this things, right? So we get the same thing. First controller, so that's my project right here. First we have to control, we have to put the controller annotation first, right? This is the called as called as annotation. If it is a controller, we have to put the annotation. It is indicated this package is a controller, right? You have to the controller. You have to implement the controller namespace above. After that, what I am going to do is here. Second one, we have these things. I just copy and paste it over here. This is the request mapping. Okay, this request mapping means you have called the index. This is the action method. Okay, when the page is loaded. We have to call the index action method so that the page is loaded. So that we have to request mapping the so get request. All are get request, right? Not post anything else. When you click the link, your page is get loaded. So we have to only call the get method, right? So we have to get this one. We have to implement the relevant namespace request mapping. That's the only thing we need, right? This again we have to call the method. Right, that's the thing we have to do. Now let's do the remaining stuff. That's the only thing we have to do. Okay. Now let's run and check whether it's working fine or not. Select the this is your main file, right? This is Java main file, right? You have to run the main file. Select this one first one, this one. Run Java application. If it is, you can check here. This our Spring Boot is working properly. Here the problem between here is I am not using any database here, so I just we have to solve this problem. Simple, let's go to your main file. This one here, you have to add this line. Okay, I will this line, right? Okay, I'll give you this line. Okay, you have to give enable auto configuration, exclude data source. This configuration, Ctrl C to copy this one. I have to add it here. That's why there error might be. Okay, save all. Don't worry about that, I will provide this code. Alright, now let's run and check again. Select here, run Java application. Now it's working. Okay, it's working perfectly. Now let's run and check whether it's working fine or not. Now it's working. The white label error, but the error here is the mapping is the problem. That's why it's telling this error. So let's solve the error. This kind of error related to the template error. See, this is a template, right? This template means you always your HTML file should put into your template folder, right? It's okay. The problem is here. I think the index.html, the navigation should be the problem. This file is reside on common. I put it the common. That's a problem, right? That's the problem, I think. Right. Now let's check it and run the application again. Check. Go to the debug. This one your project is running. Terminate and relaunch. Now let's check. Right, it's working. Now it's working. Here, the problem is there is a problem. Right? That's only the problem. I gave the folder name wrongly. That's why it take the problem as a byte error. Right? Byte error means your page is not loaded. These two contents are not loaded. That's why you get the error. Now it's working perfectly well. I will explain it. Wait, I'll do another two pages. I already done here in my demo web. This same page, I just copy. This copy and paste it here as well, inside the template folder. Select and paste it. Right, now let's run and I check again. Now it's working well, no error. Go to what's the problem about us. Working. Alright, the problem is might be here. The about us page, the common. I put it as a common. This one your common. Same thing contact us also. You have to change the folder name. That would be the problem. Right. I will explain it. Don't worry about that. Now let's again run it. Debug. Right click. Launch. About us, now it's working. Go to the contact us, it's working. Right now what does here is I will explain step by step. First I have created the this one controller. After that I have created the this one should be the page, right? This is a page design, right? So here this is a full nav tag. Here you have a bootstrap, you have the nav tag, right? I have put it to the separate HTML page. I have created created the command folder. Inside the command folder, header, if you have a footer also, you have put it like a include. Okay, include file how to use in Spring Boot. You like this, you have put it the command command file, and you have header. Header, you have to put it the all the what is the style. You have put it the, inside the HTML attack. You have put it here. You have to write the fragment, right? TH fragment header. Right, you have to write. Then not this is the efficient way you have to write. Okay, our nav tag also, this also the include tag. So FG program, you have to include the nav tag. What the nav tag you are typing, this all the nav tag should be there. This only thing you have having. Okay, this only thing you having in the HTML. Right, the same thing you have to call it into where this nav tag and inside the HTML header. Right, these two things we have to call into the HTML tag. So we have to call it the tag, but you are there, you have to call it like this th replace inside the command. We have a header here. What is the call? You have to write like this, put two semicolon and call it in Spring Boot. The same thing, what is inside there in the nav bar, you have to call it here inside the header.html. So you have to write header, common header, but the nav bar contents you have to put it here. This is the stuff you have to do, right? After that, when the page is loaded, it get called the method index. It is returned into the index page. It's mapping to the index page. It returned into the index page. After that, when you are called index page, this is the header we have to write. Okay. Okay. Here we have to call into the about us page. You have to create the link like this. The hyperlink. This is the at. This is the about us page. Or this is a contact us page. You have to call it this like this. Simple. Right, you have to write the application simply like this. Very simple. This is how we have to make the Spring Boot application. Very simple way. Don't worry about this. All the source code I will provide in my website tutorsfunny.com. I will be providing the things. I hope you understood the things well. If you have any doubt on this, you can ask me anytime. If you like my channel, please subscribe me, like me.